Now let's prove 1 plus cosine x is equal to sine squared x all over 1 minus cosine x. Obviously, this side is more complicated, so this is the side that I'm going to simplify. And by simplifying the numerator, I could change it by using factoring. I know that 1 minus cosine squared x is a special square of binomial that I can factor out. So by squaring or by factoring special squares of binomial, if I have a squared minus b squared, you can factor it out or split it into two by multiplying a plus b and a minus b. And this is the principle that I'm going to use to change my numerator. So now I have 1 minus cosine x times 1 plus cosine x, which I know I can simplify because I can cancel 1 minus cosine x and 1 minus cosine x, leaving me with 1 plus cosine x. Therefore, I proved my identity by using the factoring method that I used on the first step. So 1 plus cosine x is equal to 1 plus cosine x. Now for my fourth example, I have cosine theta all over 1 plus sine theta plus 1 plus sine theta all over cosine theta, and I need to prove it that it's equal to 2 secant theta. The first side right here is more complex, so that's why I'm going to simplify this fraction part right here. And my first instinct is to add the fraction, and that is what I'm going to do. So I added the fraction, so I have cosine squared theta plus 1 plus sine theta quantity squared all over the product of the denominator. Now, my second term right here, which is 1 plus sine theta, is squared, so I can expand it using multiplication of two binomials. So I have 1 plus sine theta times 1 plus sine theta that I will multiply. So 1 times 1 will give me 1, and then 1 plus sine theta is equal to sine theta, and sine theta plus 1 is also equal to sine theta, so I have 2 sine theta in my middle term, and sine theta plus sine theta will give me sine squared theta, and this will be my simplest form for my two binomials. And by doing so, I can see that cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta right here can be combined to be changed into 1, because by Pythagorean identity, I know that I can simplify these two terms right here so that I can change it into 1. Now my fraction is a little bit more or less complicated by using the Pythagorean identity. Now, I haven't proved that this fraction is equal to 2 secant theta because obviously they're not the same. So I'm going to need more steps in simplifying this side of the equation to make it look like 2 secant theta.